Smell it in the air. It's coming. We're gonna get caught up with this, what's gonna happen. There's something for the best.
Well, I'm good, but I worry about my pets. I can't find them in my house, and I just everything.
CBS News Update. I'm Bill Raycock.
WDZ News Time 202. Well, there was some wild wind blowing around the Detroit area last night. A lot of power lines were brought down, leaving hundreds of thousands of people in the dark. Utility spokesman Peter Kern says it'll probably be the end of the day tomorrow before everyone's back on longer. He's warning people to be cautious when outdoors because of all the damn floods. Last night's strong winds left some people without electricity in New Hampshire. Right now, about 10,000 are still in the dark, and Eversource says those people should be back on by tonight. Part of 293 in Manchester was closed because the wind pushed low-hanging lines across the road. Fewer than 400 people are without power here in Massachusetts. But coming up, students are protesting at the NRA convention in Dallas. WDZ News Time 203, traffic and weather together. Rob Hackett is here. Corners of the Lincoln All-Wheel Drive, traffic on the bridge.
Again, this year on the low restriction, 128 delays starting now southbound near the Pike Intercity down past Route 9, and more delays from 95 in Canton down to Route 20 with a rainbow. The northbound side busy from 145 in Denver to Route 9, 95 northbound is slow from the Ponson Street in Norwood up to Route 28. Route 3 is not too bad along the South Shore. The expressway southbound is 73 out of the Odeo. 2 down to the Gas Zone, Curtis Brook down to the Split. Northbound is slow to Ponson up to Andrews Square and Mass Ave up to the Odeo Tunnel. Downtown, the lower deck is backed out Sullivan Square onto the Zay Tunnel under connector busy most of the way down to Sterling. Not too bad over to Tillman or in the airport tunnels. Pike East a little slow near Newton Corner. North of town, Route 1, both ways busy near Route 60. 93 north to Chevy Montville Ave up to 128. 128 southbound is slow from Main Street, actually Walnut Street in Linfield, now down to the Cloverleaf. We also have reports of big delays in New Hampshire. 93 south is due to a crash. But is the road closed up by exit 12 in Concord, New Hampshire? Next report, 213, WDZ's traffic on the threes.